Controlling a dinghy like the 420 requires both the crew and driver to understand several factors that contribute to performance boat handling. Sailboats, and especially dinghies, must have the sails, crew weight, steering, and the heads of the driver and crew all working in unison to exhibit real control. Just as riding a bicycle requires a rider to manage turning the handlebars, pumping the pedals, and using balance to lean into a turn, sailing on all boats requires the same attention to direction, mechanics, and balance. There are three ways to steer the boat. The first and most obvious is the tiller, which controls a rudder angle. This changes the boat's direction, just as turning the handlebars on a bike allows a bicycle to turn through changing the wheel's attitude. But just as a bike needs balance, so does a 420. The crew and driver can steer the boat by moving their weight to windward or leeward, altering the boat's heel to help maintain a straight path. The most unique features for steering a dinghy are the sails. Each sail develops its own lift and exerts its own force on a different end of the boat. Separating the two is a centerboard, which represents a balancing point for the center of effort from each sail. In technical terms, the centerboard is referred to as a center of lateral resistance. When trimmed well, the main and jib each exert force laterally and forward to propel the boat, and together they promote a balanced boat. If you were to trim the main but leave the jib eased, the lateral force of the main exerted after the centerboard would increase the helm in the boat or the boat's desire to turn to windward. Likewise, easing the main with a well-trimmed jib would cause the boat to turn to leeward, creating leeward helm. This is simple stuff, but let's say you have the boat pointed straight into the wind and no motion through the water. How can the sails help you steer your way onto a course where the boat can sail? Backwing and the jib can push the bow to the opposite side and turn the boat to leeward so that the team can get back onto a sailable course. Because a jib is a crew's responsibility, this just further reinforces the importance of teamwork to sail these boats. Because of the airfoil shape of the sails and centerboard, a dinghy sails most efficiently in a straight line when sailed flat. When the boat is balanced, the sails present themselves best, and the centerboard can reach as deep as possible in the water. On some boats, trapezes are used so that a crew's weight can gain more leverage and help keep the boat flat in heavier wind. Generally speaking, though, a boat will want to turn to windward if the boat heels to leeward for a number of reasons. For one, the shape of the hull and its carving motion through the water almost steers the boat towards the wind. The opposite is true if the boat heels to windward. The boat will turn to leeward. The crew can use this to their advantage to carve the boat through a tack or jibe, using their weight to help steer the boat. When you can put all of these pieces together, a team can command the boat to stop, start, and perform maneuvers in tight situations with traffic on all sides. Ultimately, they will master the feel of the boat, and all the moves will become second nature. This doesn't come without its lumps, but getting the boat back on its feet is half the fun sometimes and often proves to be a determining factor of success in future races. Even the most practiced sailors may not be able to avoid every problem, but they always know how to recover quickly from a spill and get back into the game.